Hi there, Mini owners. Today in your 2016 Mini Cooper S, we're going to be taking a look at and showing you how to install Roadmaster's diode 7-wire to 6-wire Flexo-Coil wiring kit. Your diode wiring is one of 5 main components you'll need when flat towing your vehicle behind your motorhome. In addition to your diode wiring, you'll need your base plate, which is the connection point for your tow bar, your tow bar, which is the connection between your motorhome and your vehicle, your safety cables, which is a supplemental connection in addition to your tow bar, and your supplemental braking system, which applies the brakes in your vehicle when you hit the brakes in your motorhome. And this is what our diode wiring looks like when it's installed. All the components are going to be hidden behind our taillight assembly on the inside of the vehicle, so you don't even really know that they're there. This allows us to take all the lighting signals from our motorhome, send them to the lights here at the back of the vehicle so people around us know our intentions with going down the road, and the diodes prevent any of that current coming from our motorhome from back feeding into the circuitry on our vehicle, so we don't have to worry about any damage from our vehicle occurring due to that signaling coming from our motorhome. There are other lighting options out there that you could use instead of diode wiring, such as magnetic lights. Magnetic lights will stick on the back of the vehicle, and you will have a wiring that runs from those lights up to the front where you can connect it to your motorhome. Now, this is a nice setup if you're planning on having multiple vehicles or if you don't want to modify your vehicle, but otherwise you've got something on your vehicle that's not the prettiest thing when going down the road, and a lot of vehicles don't necessarily have magnetic roofs on the top that you can connect them to. A lot of components are plastic or aluminum, which may require you to stick the lights on the side or someplace that's even less appealing. In addition to that, even though there are non-abrasive pads on the stick lights, it's not uncommon over time for those pads to start to wear and then potentially cause small scratches and abrasions to your vehicle. But with our diode wiring, all of our components are completely hidden and our vehicle looks entirely stock when it's installed.
The only thing that you will see is your connection point here at the front. This 6-pole connector comes included with our kit, and our coiled cable that has a 6-pole end also comes with our kit. We'll plug into it, and the other end will then go into our 7-pole connector at the back of our motorhome. This is where all the signals will transfer down through our connector here, down our wiring to the diodes at the back. What I really like about this is that this connector is always here at the front of the vehicle, so we don't have to really get anything out. We don't have to set anything up. We just plug our cable in between the two, and bam, our lighting signals are being sent and our lights are working properly.
We'll begin our installation by removing the panel at the back of the vehicle so we can access the trunk pan here. That just pulls up. There's nothing that holds it in there. And you'll see a grommet located here. Just pop that grommet up using your screwdriver, and this is our access hole that we're going to run our wiring in. So just poke your wiring through there, and it'll come out here just above your exhaust. There's a heat shield down there that it's going to sit on top of, and just start pulling that wiring out and leave yourself some access in here, because this is what we're going to hook up to our taillights at the back. We'll now access our taillight assemblies, pull the panel out on the driver's side, and this will access your wiring for your taillight assembly.
We'll disconnect the connector here, press in on the release tab. It's on the opposite side, so it's towards the outside of the vehicle, and then just pull the connector off. There's your small release tab right there. It is a little bit difficult to press that down, but it does come off of there. Once you've got that off, we're gonna cut this little bit of sheathing off here. So just gently cut it. You can use a razor knife as well. And sometimes it helps to pull it and then cut it, because we don't want to damage the wiring. You can then unwrap it. And we're going to take that off there. And now we'll need to identify our stop and tail light wiring. Our stop light is going to be the black with yellow stripe. So we're going to separate that one. And then our tail light is going to be the gray with violet stripe. So we'll separate that one out as well. We can now cut both of these wires and then strip back each end. Once you've got each end stripped back, we'll take the diodes that come in our kit, and we're going to pull off blue spade terminals for each one of these wires. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4. and we're going to crimp a spade terminal onto each one of these wires. It's a little bit easier if you twist the wire. That keeps the wires from kind of poking backwards when you try to slide the spade terminal. It just helps it go on a little easier. Just poke the wire in and then crimp it down. We'll do the same thing for the remaining three wires. We can now take our wiring and we're going to start connecting it to our diodes on this side. So we're going to need three wires for this side. We'll need one for our stoplight and one for our taillight. But then we also need that third wire to extend the taillight that we're attaching on this side over to the passenger side, so that way our passenger side taillight also works. One of the ways I've found to accomplish this without requiring any extra wiring is to use part of our white wire to do so. Your white wire is your ground wire, but we can use a small section of it because we can attach our ground wire at any point on the frame of the vehicle. So what we're going to do then is cut each wire in between, and this will allow us to separate them back. The green wire is going to go off towards the passenger side, so we're just going to stretch that back, making sure that we can get over there. And these remaining wires, we're going to route over to this side. Now we want to make sure we've got enough white wire to be able to make it from this side over to the passenger side. So we're just kind of going to eyeball it here at first to get an idea of how much white wire we're going to need. And this looks like a pretty good amount right here. So what you can do now is take the white wire here further down, and we're just going to cut it. Try not to cut the brown wire when doing so. So just gently snipping the white. And what we can do now is we can take our white wire and separate it all the way down to where we made that cut. And now we've got our wire that we can use to extend it from one side to the other. To make our installation a little bit cleaner, we're going to route the wiring down and then behind this paneling up. So we'll remove these two pins here. These pins, they look like a solid pin, but they're actually two separate pieces. So take your screwdriver and put it between the two pieces first and pop the center out. Then the rest of it will likely come out afterwards, but you can see that there are two, and you have to separate these two in order for the pin to come out. We'll do the same with the other one. And if you want, you can do this on the opposite side as well, because we're going to be routing the green wire and the white wire that we're running across behind the carpet over there. Once we've got those pulled out, we can pull our paneling back some, and we're just going to use that to feed our wiring up. Now that we've got our wires routed up, strip all those back, and what we're going to do here is we're going to take the brown and the white, and we're going to twist those two together. And this is going to crimp onto the single yellow spade terminal that comes in your kit. The yellow terminal has a larger inner diameter, making it easy to fit the two wires inside. For our yellow wire, we're just going to crimp on another blue spade terminal like the rest of our wiring. We can now connect our diodes. The single pin on your diode is the out, and that's always going to go towards your connector end because that's towards your taillight assembly. So we're going to plug the out for each diode into the connector side. And then on our inside, we need to connect the appropriate wires. So the other end of the wires that we cut, these are going to connect to the inside, so just make sure you match up the colors. So black and yellow goes back to black and yellow, and then gray and violet goes back to gray and violet. Since our gray and violet is our tail lamp circuit, that's going to use the brown and white wire that we crimped together. So just poke that onto the other end. And then our yellow wire is our stoplight signal. So that's going to plug into the other for our black and yellow circuit. Now, there are sticky pads. This is mostly carpeted on the inside, so there's really not a good place for it to stick to. So you can just peel off the adhesive backing and then stick the two diodes together, and that'll help keep them from bouncing around into each other making some noise. We can then plug our wire connector back into our taillight assembly. On our passenger side, we routed our wiring over. Everything was pretty much the same on this side. The only small difference we're going to have is that the green wire is our brake light wire, so that's going to plug on the inside between our black and yellow wire, just like on the driver's side. But on our passenger side, the taillight, instead of being gray with violet, it's gray with yellow. And the white wire that we had connected to the brown wire on the driver's side and run over connects to the in for this diode. On this side also, in order to get the wire routed up behind the carpet, there is a small plastic piece here you have to remove. A T25 Torx socket removes the single bolt, and then you can just pull that out. And that way you can get your carpet pulled out to get that wiring run. We can then take the grommet that we removed. We're going to snip it down the middle. And it is a little bit brittle. It's okay. We're going to use some silicone on it to seal it back up. So we're just going to put some silicone down around the rim. And then we can work our grommet over the wire. It might be easier to cut a small notch out of your grommet and then just fill that in with silicone due to how brittle the grommet is because it's painted. So we cut a little notch out of it there. We'll slip that over our wiring and then poke it down in there. We can then put some more silicone on top and seal that all the way up. This will ensure that no exhaust gases make their way into the vehicle. You also want to make sure you put your panels back in. What I'm going to do too is I'm going to place this cardboard on top of where we put the silicone. It feels pretty tacky, like it's dried up, but just in case, I don't want it to go onto our paneling there. So that'll ensure that it can fully dry without transferring over. The wiring here at the back will now route to the front of the vehicle where we'll connect to our 6-pole connector. I've already routed it. I'll show you the path I took to get it there. It started by coming out back here above our heat shield and the exhaust. I went ahead and took it and went behind the bumper towards the passenger side and then came on top of this black panel here going forward. It comes out here at the top of the panel. We stayed above our rear suspension and then came down and went below the fuel tank. From here we went above our undershield and stayed above the undershield all the way towards our front subframe, where we came out here following our factory hose. And then we went above the front subframe and stayed above our front undershield all the way forward. You might need to remove a couple of the bolts here on the side just so you can pull the panel down to make it easier. An 8mm socket will take those off. We came out here at the front of the panel. And I did route it up and left some excess here next to our washer bottle, because if you're going to add any accessories to your flat tail setup, such as braking systems, you will need to tap into this wiring most likely. And then we just came right back down and went over to our connector here at the front where we're going to mount our 6-pole. And if you remember the white wire that we had cut before when we jumped it across, the length that we cut came out pretty good to where it was near our rear subframe here. So we attached the ring terminal that comes in our kit to the white wire and then used the included self-tapping screw and ran it into the subframe here using an 8mm socket. Now you'll notice here that our fascia is removed. When we installed our base plate, we had to remove the fascia to do so. And that's a great opportunity to do your wiring while your fascia is removed, because you've got easy access to the front here. So if you have any other flat toe components that you're going to be installing, I recommend you put a hold on your diode wiring for now and finish installing those while you got your fascia off. Once you've got all that complete and you got your fascia back on, we're going to pick right back up at that point and we'll show you how to get this wiring connected to your 6-pole. Now, if you are curious how we got the fascia removed, then I would recommend that you check out our base plate installation video. Our base plate is part number RM-521882-5. And if you search your 16
Mini Cooper, you should see that video there and you can follow along with us.
After your fascia is on, in order for your six-pole connector to fit, you are going to have to trim out a small section here for the back side of the connector to fit. We're just going to use a pair of snips to trim this out. We've got a lot of excess that we don't need here. I do like to leave some excess so that way if we need to make any repairs or pull this connector out, we can actually pull it out and get to the back side of it. So we're going to come down to maybe about here. That should give us plenty for the future. And just trim off all that excess. Once again, we're going to cut between each wire to separate them. And then we can pull them back. We'll then take the rubber sleeve, which goes over the back of your six pole, slide that over your wiring first, and then we can strip back each of those wires. You'll then need a small Phillips head screwdriver to loosen the screws located on the back of your six pole connector. We're going to be loosening the ones labeled TM, which is our taillights, GD, which is ground, LT, which is left turn, and RT, which is right turn. The other two we'll save for the future and can be used for additional accessories that you may add. So since they are all labeled on there, we're just going to poke the wires in. Our brown wires are taillights, so we'll just go ahead and start there. And that is TM. And it just pokes in. And then we can tighten that screw back down. We'll then continue connecting the rest of the wires. The white wire will go to GD. The green wire will go to RT. And the yellow wire will go to LT. Once you've got all of your connections made, put some dielectric grease on the back side. This will help keep out any moisture and prevent corrosion. And it's okay to be kind of generous with the dielectric grease. Now that you've covered it in grease, you can slide your dust cover over it. And what I like to do to seal it all up in there, keep the grease from coming out, is to just take some electrical tape and wrap it around both the front and back side of our dust cap. And then we can mount it to the mounting location on our base plate. The mounting hardware comes included with your base plate. It's just a couple of self-tapping screws. And they just poke in there and you can tighten them in using an 8mm socket. Now I will say these screws fit in there a little bit on the loose side. So you want to be gentle going in with them. You don't want to over-tighten them because you can strip them out. With our fascia back in place, we're ready to connect it to the back of our motorhome and test everything out. You can now plug it into your motorhome to verify that everything's working. We're going to plug in a tester here. We want to make sure that you have your left turn signal, right turn signal, tail lamps, and brake lamps. And with everything working properly, we're now ready to connect our vehicle to the back of our motorhome and hit the road.